Amen. Our first prayer point today, as we start the service, we want to thank God for bringing us this far as individuals. We want to thank God for bringing us this far as families, for bringing us this far as a church. We want to thank God for bringing us this far. Psalms, go with me to Psalms 150, verse 6. So, 150. Psalms 150, verse 6. Amen. You're there, you better let me know. But we need to give thanks to God. And it's in that action of giving thanks that we prepare. We make the way clear for God's miracles to live in our lives. Amen. So, Psalms 150, verse 6 says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. You see, we have come this far. And the very fact that we have come this far, that the Lord has carried you, the Lord has carried your family, the Lord has carried us as a church. Amen. We need to give thanks. We need to thank Him. We need to honor Him. We need to say, thank you, Lord, for keeping us. Thank you, Lord, for carrying us. Amen. So go ahead and thank Him. Father, we thank you, Father God, this day. Father, Lord, we thank you.
Benefits in our lives. Amen.
So we're going to thank Him. We are going to thank Him for know the scripture by now. Amen. 5 verse 18. In this prayer point, we are thanking God for the enlargement of our church. We know God has already enlarged us. God has already put people into this place. On Friday, we've seen an influx of people. Amen. A year again. Amen. And God, we see God's word. So God has heard us. He's heard our prayers that have gone forth. So we need to thank Him for expanding this place. We need to thank Him for enlarging this church. We need to thank Him for adding this church. All over this community of Windsor East, Windsor West, Randburg, Johannesburg, the nations of South Africa, the nation of Africa. We are thanking Him. We need to thank Him for bringing those people into this place. That is why 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 18 says the following. In everything, in everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God for us. The will of God has Jesus for us. In everything we need to thank Him. For the end, every time God adds another person to this church, let us thank Him. So let us go ahead and thank Him now. Father, we thank You for coming to this church. We thank You, Lord, for answering our prayers, Father God, by sending in people, Father God, that need to hear Your word.
Take place in our midst. Go ahead and pray. Father,
Go with me to Proverbs. Proverbs 20, verse 12. And in this prayer point, we are thanking God for the opening of the eyes of the people of Windsor.
Hallelujah.
Windsor East, Windsor West.
Your eyes are
opening
open.
The eyes of people in Randburg, in Johannesburg, in South Africa, throughout this country, throughout this nation, throughout Africa. We are thanking God for opening the eyes.
Yes.
Amen. Proverbs 20 verse 12 says,
praise God.
And the year here and the sea eye, the Lord has made them whole. Amen. It's God who makes people to see. It's God who makes your eyes to open.
Hallelujah.
So now we are praying. So now let's thank God. We're thanking Him in advance for helping people to see the miracles that God has done. The opening their eyes to see that He's the source in you. That He is your source. He is your miracle worker. He is your promise keeper. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. So we want to thank Him. We want to thank Him that we are able to see the word correctly. We are able to rightly divide the word that God has sent through His servant. So we want to thank God for opening our eyes to see this church as our church.
Hallelujah.
Not someone else's church.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Tell your neighbor, this is my church.
This is my church.
This is my church. Amen. So we are praying that they come. Hallelujah. And we thank God for them coming in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So let us go in and thank
you. Oh,
Father,
in the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
that garment of heaviness you saw me. Because I can feel God moving this place over here. Amen. So God has already chosen to move amongst us. So let us put a garment of praise on as we come and we praise and worship. Are you ready to praise and worship God?
Yes.
Before we go there, let's go to Matthew. We just get you fired up. Let me send you to Matthew. Amen. Matthew 17 verse 20.
Your grace abound.
Matthew 17 verse 20 says, Jesus said to them, because of your unbelief, for surely I say to you, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed,
hallelujah,
you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing is impossible. Amen. Nothing will be impossible for you.
Amen.
We serve a God. Whatever mountain the enemy has thought to bring towards you, you can root it out by your faith.
Amen.
Have you seen the size of a mustard seed? It's this small. You can almost not see it.
Lord.
So imagine your faith is this small. You can still move that mountain.
Amen.
Amen. I'm reminded of Acts 16 verse 26 when Paul and Silas was in that prison. They could have chosen God. They chose to worship God, and we see what happened in Acts. We see what happened to them. The prison walls were shaken. The shackles came off. Whatever the enemy has bound you with, whatever the enemy has done to your mind, you can shake off today. When you praise and worship God, you allow His presence to come in.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
want to fill you, Lord God.